seen at the in the last video. That is the job we're going to do. So it's in a DAFX F105, Lutetium in Mannheim, and go to cathode in Nuremberg with it. It's a red delivery pace 4808. So let's crack on and join me in the truck. I went to the inside of the 105. Before I set off, I'm going to show you the route. I'm going to leave Mannheim road there to there and into Nuremberg, but I'm going to go right that way to pick up the scrub rules there. Let's get going, shall we?
Drive safe.
Some display on. There we go. Get her into gear and we'll go. I'd rather take a delivery out of this place and bring one in. But once you get the knack of getting in, it's not too bad, but I have not got the knack of getting into my trimmer eye.
Turn left.
On the old tree pubs.
Get ready to turn left.
We have
turn left.
5 hours, 5 minutes to get this there, and it's gonna take about 4 hours or so for us to do the job, so we'll be tight. But I love these old DAFs. You know, I like the DAF trucks.
Keep right and then turn right. Turn right.
Helping getting caught by every bloody traffic light, is it? This. Rich life. Okay. Every little job helps build the pot. We'll draw our own truck. Done a few jobs now, we're trying to build a nice little truck and get to a certain level. About to start getting like what you would term a bleed spec truck. I'm aiming to get the about the 470 horsepower or maybe a little bit more if I can. Man truck. Start to make some progress. We are fairly light, so sorry, I forgot to disable this guard. know. This is what comes in the game as standard. Nothing. No mods at all. Plenty of fuel, plenty of ad blue. It is night time, but we just bang, bang, bang on quick jobs,
right,
getting the money
and
in.
And then exit right. Exit right. Turn right.
Now we're doing it. Back on. You know, the last three models that DAP have actually put out of the ETS2 to show you how far I am from this one, which is the 105. Then there's the 106, and then there's the 2021, the ETS2 for the XG Plus, so. But they do put a classic one day, but I can't see them doing with the manufacturer's licenses and what have you, but like you see is like the XF95 in what's known as the F241 and stuff like that, in maybe the NT. Then your Volvos, the F10s, F12s, some old ARF trucks, which I doubt we'll get Ford. One, two, three, and four series Scanias. Iveco Turbo Star, the Renault Integrale. The one that became the one before the Magnum. Don't think I missed that one, mate. So they could actually make a nice, like, classic retro pack, but I don't think they ever will. Obviously licensing agreements are difficult and companies have changed hands since the manufacturers are in business. Miss Mercedes out, well, some of the old like MP1, MP2s are the ones that preceded those. I know there's mods about for some as well, so. I would really like the same game, but I don't think General Motors would ever give them a license to do this, so whoever owned them now is somebody who like Bedford's trucks. Not the little TKs, the full Arctics or the Leyland, but with Leyland ones, I'd have to go through like Packard and what have you, and I don't think license any of the older models on them, so it's a dream. Don't think it'll happen. Mind you, some of the older trucks now in the game that are in it at the start, they're classed as retro trucks anyway now. They're no longer manufactured out, so. For a long time after World 06 was released, firms could actually buy brand new 105s, order them, and they do them, but I don't think they'll do that now. For things. Do anything new in the game since I last recorded? Nothing. Apart from some things now about further stuff about the Switzerland remake that's coming in 148 to 149. Where they're redoing some like base map cities and what have you, and I think the doing a couple in Germany as well. Travel Monday, one of them, another one up there. I hope they get round to rescaling Britain and reworking Britain and putting more of it in, and Ireland and more Scotland in it as well. Yeah, but that'll be a long way off, I would think. And this is the first bread delivery we're doing, so I hope it's successful. Of course, I haven't marked it yet. We have to order a new business that was coming in the Germany remake. And if it is an electrical place, it makes sense if we're taking electronics there.
Keep right and then turn right. Turn right. Keep right.
No, not. you might hear the late music now and again because I've got to turn it off. I'll do that now. If I can remember which one it is in here. I think it's. Which one is it? No, my music's all. I think it's that one. Is. Have I made a mistake there? No. We've only got 4 miles to go now, so it's not too far.
Go straight on. Go straight on, and then turn left.
Oh.
Finding a new route.
About to be a cock-up somewhere.
Turn left. Ready to turn left. Turn left.
Yeah. Certainly a bit challenging just listening to the voice, but you get used to it.
Go straight on.
And we're approaching destination somewhere.
Get ready to turn right. Turn right.
Where are the says I don't know because I can't see it. I leave the map up. You can see where we're going. Missed it, just. Some of the businesses you can predict with the sun and new ones on new prefabs. You get when you play the game for a lot.
Finally. We are here.
Yeah, reasonable one, but I've said that before and had ash of it. Hopefully. I've switched in with it. No, I don't want to skip the parking. Job it off, get paid. We weren't late. Good delivery. So, see where we're going next. Go to Lintz. Bit Lintz before though. But that's the job that's at the top. It's with some tractors, another egg delivery. We just got to get onto this job. I know there'll be no mapping the truck in this truck either, so I'll be relying on just voice again.
Ready to roll.
That would put the whole thing into gear, wouldn't it? Oh, it's one of these trailers. Got plenty of fuel. The way it's not heavy.
Turn right.
Oh. Try and get out of here. Exactly, got the most power or getaway in the world, but they do the job. Railway. Oops. Nearly.
Ready.
Don't make sure you're open this one because you've done it before. Bit linked.
Turn right.
RTL log transfer, I'd call this one. Another truck that you can class as a retro truck now. Out the two older ones, I do prefer the older Renaults. I do like the Premium better than the Magnum. It looks more like a proper truck rather than an odd bod. It does, but I'm not knocking the Magnum. Most powerful starter truck you can get from the game is a Magnum.
Right.
They're just very basic, the old Renaults. There's no satin or inbuilt sat nav option, so you can't choose a trimmy one in. You're not the only truck that's like that in game, so
keep right and then turn right. Turn right. Keep left and then exit left.
Bit late telling me that.
Keep right.
Lady. It says 50 on Chucky there, the speed limit, so it's about 80 kilometres an hour I can do. I didn't remember to sort the keys out, otherwise I'd be... Not the first time we've had, we haven't had many. I do believe that this one will have one on the back, yeah. They have to listen to her and then look at the road signs as well. Not managing too bad. We may get skill points at the end of this job, we may not. decline steadily. Says I'm trying to control them when they start to get jobs. Delivery time sometimes a bit tight, but I've got plenty of time left over there. There's another red delivery, which we may get a few red deliveries now we've opened them up. I'm going to start to open like some of the ADR categories up. And then expand the distance ones after them a bit more. I've not done three jobs in this video, so this will be it, but might be bringing you to the job we might do next. Go and get the links, drop this off. Not doing it business specific or truck brand specific, it's just whatever's there. So I know it's not the first time using XF105 on a job, but it's not the first time we use one of these. So, you'll see some trucks more than others in the quick job, so not really one that picks and chooses. About halfway there now. If you're getting a bit of daytime in this one and the next one, you should get some as well. Set this for a high quality corner, so it might look better, it might not. I don't think we'll crack 9 miles to the gallon before we drop this job off, but we're at 8.5 now, so average. They ever will, but they could. I know you have the damage up and like obviously wear and tear on things in the game, but if they're modelled in or a truck would go like one this many miles on, like when the engines get a bit worn and stuff like that in properly. Same as if you severely damage the transmission in game, you always lose top gear. You wouldn't lose top gear all the time in real life with damaged transmission, it just wouldn't engage anything. Got little tricks you could do here and there to make it like more lifelike. Truck engine lasts in real life, I don't know. If you zoom, it's 600,000-800,000 miles. It's more like major vehicles and services. Morning air into the truck. What they've simulated in game. About these Renaults is because you've got your retarder on, it shows a blue bar up in the tachometer, rack counter. Don't do that with the engine brake.
Right. and then exit right. Exit right. Turn right.
Coming at the lens. Or on the retarder. Retarder off.
Keep right and then turn right. Turn right. Keep right and then turn right.
It's up here.
Turn right.
Window back up.
Get ready to turn right.
And we're here.
Turn right.
And where
this is where it is.
Oh, we've got an easy-ish one. Famous last words. Drop this off, get our remittance for it. Now let's see where we're going to put it. So got them opened up, so if we put it in, that allows us to carry like some petrol and stuff. So a quick preview of the next, there we go. So we are in Linz. In the multi-tech one, that'll be a video on its own, that one. I think next time we may do special transport to Brno into the Czech Republic. Yeah. So anyhow, so that'll conclude that for now. See you next time. Bye bye.